Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm back with another Goodwill Outlet haul from the one in Long Island City, and I need to start with like a little mini story time before I start this haul because it is freaking hilarious. So a lot of people, ever since I uploaded my first Goodwill Outlet haul, they asked me, like, is it as crazy as people say in the reviews and stuff? Is it as scary as people say? And I always tell them, like, it's fine. It was fine when we went. Like, there was nothing. You know, as long as you speak Spanish, you're nice to the Spanish ladies, you're fine. Like, don't get in their way, though, and you'll be fine. And this time when we went, there was literally, this was, like, the second rotation. And me and Scott were in line with all the ladies and stuff, and we are ready. And then when they let us go, we start walking out. You know, they fast, I mean, I would say it's a slow run is what they do. And these two ladies ended up like fighting with each other. They're like pushing each other. And this one lady pushed this other lady into me, into a bin. And I was like holding on to Scott for dear life. And he was like ahead of me. And I was like, no, like I'll never let go, Jack, kind of thing going on. And it was a hot damn mess. It was like so weird and so freaky. But yeah, so the Goodwill Outlet workers, or like, I don't know if he was the manager or something, but I've never seen him. Like, he must be in the back and stuff. He was like yelling. We were all looking at the stuff at this point of the rotation. He was yelling at the ladies, like, blah, 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 blah. Like, they got kicked out, y'all. They got kicked out, and like, by the time we were leaving and stuff, I told Scott I was done after that rotation, anyways, because I was already tired and my allergies was kicking, and I was just not having it, so. By the time we left, them ladies were sitting outside, like, all pissed and stuff. I was like, oh my god, I thought all of them were friends, but they were, like, pushing each other. I was like, it's not that serious. Y'all go every single day. Like, it was just crazy, but I had to share this story because people be asking me all the time on Instagram and YouTube now, like, is the Goodwill Outlet in the city as ratchet as we think it's gonna be? Like, it's not, but it is, like, compared to, I've been to the New Jersey one. Well, there was one in New Jersey, and I've been to the Maine one. Those were completely lax compared to this outlet. Let's just say that. And I really think they should open another Goodwill outlet in New York, like upstate or something, or a little like outside the city, like up more, and it'll be probably more relaxed. I think people like bug out because it's the only one in New York. So yeah. Anyways, that is my quick little story. I hope y'all didn't get bored of that, but I had to share because people really ask me, and I want you guys to know, like, it is safe, but, like, it's just like any other outlet. People are intense. People are in, like, beast mode. They're looking for stuff, but this one, they're just a little more pushy and don't listen to the rules. That's all I can say. And they're nice ladies. They seem nice, all of them, but they were pushing. They don't care how small you are. I'm small, guys. I'm like 5 feet tall and petite, and I'm tiny, and people will push you with their bags and stuff. It is crazy. But yeah, we did manage to find a few things, not too much, because, you know, I was kind of like bugged out when I got pushed into the bin. I got like sandwich. I was like, oh, like, I wasn't ready for that. But anyways, we managed to get kind of a full bag, and then this mini half bag, Trader Joe's bag of like books and stuff. It's not full by any means, but we did pick up a few. I wanted to start with the books because it's easier that way. The books at this outlet are $3 for $1 typically. So yeah, in case you're wondering about price. So we did manage to find a few things. Scott picked this up just for, I think, him. And it seems cool. It's the Gamer's Edition. It'll be an interesting read. And I think he picked that up for himself. Or maybe his brother. I'm not entirely sure. And then we picked up a lot of stuff, because by the end of it, I wasn't having all the shenanigans. So yeah, we picked up this book. It's like a France book. It's kind of like, you know, those books where you like pick them up before you travel to places so you can find out about them and stuff. But the cover is obviously dead, but I wanted to pick it up anyways with the cover just because I can use that for something. But this is what the book looks like. I'm sorry if you hear JJ in the background. He's in my brother's room right now crying for attention. But the graphics in this book were really amazing. And I thought it was definitely worth the price. I was worried it was going to be by weight. I would have picked up way more books. So maybe next time I'll just like peek around the books and stuff. That's one of my favorite places to look in these outlets because I love getting books for super cheap. Next, we got this book. I really like the cover of it. I think it would make like a good junk journal to gut and stuff. But it's called Butcher Baker Murder Maker by members of the Mystery Writers Club of, well, Writers of America. So I just thought the cover was cool. I could always gut it. I don't think it's that old. Let me see. 1954. Let me find the date on this France one. I love this France one so much. Like, y'all don't even know. If I could have found a New York one, that would have made me really happy. That one is 1950. The cover made a mess in this bag, so that's kind of annoying. But I'll just clean it out later. So next, I picked up this little Curious George book. This one was basically free. Like, they didn't really charge for all these thin, tiny books. I just thought the graphics were cool for, like, I could use it for a kids' theme journal or something. Also picked up this Little Mermaid book. It's really beat. I plan to cut it up. It's from 1991. And, you know, it's just typical graphics in these little golden books. I just like it. I love the Little Mermaid. So pick that up. Also picked up this modelage. Why did I even try to say this? This is definitely French. correct me because I don't speak French, so I don't know. But I love how French looks. This is from 1938 and I just thought it was an awesome kids book. And I love the paper. It's like craft paper they use. So it like really like looks really vintage, even though it's not. I mean, 1938 is pretty old now, but you know, it's not that old, but yeah. Also picked up this Reader's Digest Condensed Books. This one, compared to all the other ones, has a pretty plain cover, but I liked the fact that it was plain. This is from 1991. So this one is, I think, the youngest of all the ones that I've bought. But I liked how clean it looked. I thought this would look great as a journal. And then we also picked up, this one's kind of random, but I thought the graphics were really cool. It's a guide to field identification of birds in North America. Look at their hair. So cute. Anyways, 1966 is when this is from. I just really like the graphics. I'm not going to go field hunting. I mean, not hunting, but bird watching. You know what people do. But this is really cool. And I could probably use the pages for something. And then someone must have donated like all of their Michelin tourist guides. And I picked up the ones that I could find. So I picked up the Paris one. Ooh. Oh yeah, I found these like old ads in the bottom. And I just like picked them all up because they're so cool. But this one is for Paris. Let's see. Do these have dates in them? I don't know. But this one looks different than all the other ones. This one looks newer, maybe. But I thought this would be cool to have. Graphics-wise, I don't think I'm going to keep them. This one is for Austria and the Bavarian Alps. Yeah, these look older. Or just feels like more recycled paper kind of feel. This one is for Italy. Sorry about the plane. I live near JFK, if y'all don't already know. And then the last one is Switzerland. And yeah, the graphics, pretty cool. I like this, the idea of having these. Oh, here's the receipt. We spent a total of $28, which is actually around the same price we paid the first time we went, so. So the first thing that I see on top is this American Apparel shirt. It's a button down. It's men. I think it's a men's shirt, right? Looks like a men's shirt, like a medium. Just a plain white button down. Let me zoom out. Oops. So it's this plain white button-down shirt, you know, nothing special, but American Apparel is a brand that typically always sells, especially on Posh. So now that Posh has men's like stuff for sale too, you can sell it more easy. More easy, is that a word? Yeah, that's... Next thing we found, actually Scott picked this up. It's this loft dress and it's a size small. And it is really cool. It has this like, I don't think this is genuine leather. It's probably pleather. But it's really cute. It's gray. Reminds me of like a business dress, like, but it's got like these leather pockets and then top up here. I think this would be really cute and would probably do well on Posh. But honestly, if this fits me really nice, I might keep this. It's cute. Super cute. And then next we picked up this Zara, like, guess you could call it a cardigan. Like, you know those open cardigans that are like loosey in the open? Wow, this looks terrible on camera, but you guys get the idea. These are cute with like leggings and stuff. We got a lot of gray, I just realized that. And then we also picked up this Madewell shirt in extra small. It's just, well, it's a cardigan. And it's this cardigan with the buttons, and it's got this like tealy blue, like light teal, like almost like a seafoam green on the inside there. There's just one little run right here, which doesn't look too bad at all. Just like little pockets here. So yeah, pick that up. That was actually in like an almost empty bin, because for those of you who don't already know, when you go to this Goodwill outlet, the ladies tend to, once they put a new rotation out, they literally dump entire bins into their bags and then dump it into their carts, go through it, and then dump it back. So that was in an empty, basically an empty bin, and they missed it. So that's the problem with stuffing things into your cart and not looking, you know? So this next thing is a Madewell sweater, well, like a sweatshirt, size small. And this one was really cute. It has a bunch of like famous cities on it. I think this is really cute. But once again, more gray, another gray thing. Wow, we really did a lot of gray. This is just an Abercrombie and Fitch sweater. Typically, I don't really pick this up, but on Posh, it'll do just fine. So let me zip it for you guys to show you what it looks like. So it has this kind of zipper. You know the one where it's like over, it's not directly in the middle, it's more towards one other side of the chest. So I thought this was unique and cute. And it was in great condition. It seemed like everyone had donated all their winter stuff already and was ready to like move into the spring and summer clothes. So that was a good thing because people will be buying it all year round. So this next thing is an Ann Taylor Loft sweater, size medium, new with tags. And it still has all the stickers and stuff. And it's this pretty purpley color. I really like the pattern up here, and it was really good. It was selling at Goodwill for $8.99, which is, whew, that's pretty expensive. Also picked up this J. Crew shirt, size 4. It's just a simple, like, striped shirt, but the material is, like, really great. It's, like, thin. Let's see if I could find... Oh, it's 100% silk. That's why it feels so good. But it's like really nice, it feels great. And then next we picked up this little tank top. I think I'm keeping this for myself. I just need more tank tops for the summer. And it just has this really cute top. It almost mimics like a corset kind of look. I don't think I looked this up at all. Keeping this for myself. And then next, we picked up this J. Crew pants, size 2. No style. It's like a high-waisted pant. It's very, like, it looks vintage, but it obviously isn't. But yeah, I thought this was kind of cute. Not really entirely sure if Scott picked this. I think he did. He picked up a lot of pants. Then next, ooh, I was really excited about this. It's like this, let's see if I can find a tag. It's this vintage, like, lingerie, and it's a size large. I wish it was small. I would have kept it. And it's by the, it's Glencraft Lingerie, and it's by the Ladies Garment Union Made, Workers Union. And I heard that does pretty good. So this is what it looks like. It's black and lacy up top. It's really pretty. Like, that is really gorgeous. I would have definitely kept this if it was my size. But yeah, I was really excited to find that. I always look for the, like, lacy kind of vintage nightgown kind of feel because I love the just how they look and I just love them. This I picked up because I feel like my sister would want it, and if she doesn't, I'll just sell it on Posh. It's American Eagle. It's an extra small. So it's American Eagle, it's an extra small. It's just a plain tank that, like, is loosey-goosey on the bottom, but it has a cute V-neck. So yeah, if she doesn't want it, I'll probably keep it, if anything. Then we also found another American Apparel shirt, but this one's like a tank top. And it's a size medium. It's probably a men's too. I'm not sure. The fit almost looks like it would be a woman's, like, you know, those kind of loosey tank tops that you wear with leggings and stuff. I'm gonna have to look it up because I'm not entirely sure. Some of their stuff is like unisex looking anyways. Next, we picked up this Juicy hoodie and it's in little girl size. It's so cute. This is what the back looks like. Let me. It's so cute. It's like a little peplum. And then the hood has these ruffles. So cute. It's a size 2 toddler. And this will definitely sell. Then we also found this little dress. It's from Bonnie Baby. And it's a 12 month. I mean, no, it's not a dress. It's a romper pantsuit kind of thing. I remember finding this. I'm super excited about this. I want to keep it, like, for my kid. It's for 1 year old. And it's got the prettiest buttons that look like little pearls. And I love the little collar. I just love everything about it. The color. Like, I was really excited when I thought it was a dress. But then I got even more excited when I knew it was a pantsuit kind of jumpsuit thing. Then we picked up this mango suit skirt in a size 6. And it's just this plain black skirt. It's kind of like a skater skirt. It's got some pleats. And yeah, I just picked it up because I like mango. And this was really cute. Next, we picked up, this was really random, but I had to do it. It's a J. Crew, like, dress. Gown looking thing, size 2, new with tags, and it is really pretty. This was, there was like quite a few gowns in there, like someone must have just donated it, but look at it, it's beautiful. It's a little messed up on the bottom, but like nothing steaming won't fix. Like, it's really pretty, and it's also my size, so it makes me really sad, but I don't think I can keep this because why do I need this? But it's so pretty, right? I haven't looked it up yet, but I saw a gown new with tags, and I was like, oh, let me pick it up. It's really pretty. It would be really pretty for spring, or like a photo shoot or something. Then we picked up this Tommy Hilfiger sweater, size medium. I just liked the quality of it. Scott found this, and I don't know. It's just unique. Just looks different. So we picked that up. Also picked up this blue one, very similar, but it's Ann Taylor Loft, size small. There's a lot of Ann Taylor Loft as usual. There's always a lot of loft stuff in the outlets, and I mean Goodwill Outlet and Goodwill. But yeah, so it kind of has a high-low kind of thing going on, and this is really cute. I don't know, I can't keep it. I have too many sweaters, but that would be really cute with leggings. then we picked up this striped shirt, and it's Brandy Melville. This will definitely sell on, wait, is this a dress? I don't know, it's one size. It's really long. Okay, maybe this is a t-shirt dress? Even better. I saw Brandy Melville and I had to pick it up. This is kind of hurting my eyes though, I'm not gonna lie. But this will definitely sell on Posh. Teenagers love this brand for some reason. I actually have a lot of Brandy Melville stuff on my Posh. And I've sold a lot of Brandy Melville on my Posh. This next thing is an Abercrombie skirt, brand new with tags. It was on clearance for $28.99, originally sold for $38. Dang, that's expensive. It's a size 2. It's my size. But it's this quilted material. It is so strange. It's, hold on, let me put it. It's like weird. It's like a fold over skirt. It's so strange. But yeah, it's brand new with tags. I don't know. Maybe it'll be someone's style, not mine. All these ties, I believe we picked up for Scott because he doesn't have any ties. We are building up his tie collection, y'all. We don't even dress up that often, but now for any occasion, he'll have a tie. Actually, this might... Is this peachy to you or pinky to you? Because my sister's wedding, he does need a pinky tie. So anyways, so we picked up this tie. It's from thetiebar.com. But yeah, he doesn't have any ties this color. Then we picked up, we always pick up lavendery ties because that's my favorite color. So we picked up this tie and I don't know where it's from. Oh, nope. Don't know where it's from, but it feels good, feels silky. This one is Romario Manzini, sounds Italian. And it is this pink and yellow design. I mean, like, these are all for him. If he doesn't end up liking them, we can always sell it. So it doesn't really matter. And then this next thing I picked up is this Zara baby boy, like chambray kind of button down shirt. It's so cute. I want to keep it. It's size 18 to 24 months. It's so cute. Reminds me of like Bruno Mars for some reason. Then we picked up this pair of Levi's. I was looking desperately for Levi's that would kind of fit me so I could cut it, but I don't know. This is a 536, size 28 and 34, so I don't know. We'll see. I mean, it's obviously men's, right? But I don't know. It kind of looks like it would be women's, the design on it. But we shall see. The bottoms are gross, but I plan to cut it anyways, so it doesn't really bother me. Next, we got this pair of Levi's, I believe, as well, in a demi curve, low rise skinny. Focus. And it is a size 3, which I didn't even know they had. This one feels good. Might keep this if it fits me, which probably will, might be a little big, but it's like, feels like jeggings. Feels good. It's this dark wash color, which I shouldn't have gotten because super dark washes don't always do too well. But, I don't know, I just picked it up. We weren't finding a lot, so I just ended up picking it up. And then we picked up this jacket, Du Perdu, size 4. Don't know about the brand, but I just wanted a long, like, looks like a coat, but it's not. It's like a suit top. I wanted a big blazer that looks like a coat. I don't know. And this one fit perfectly. So I might keep it. I might sell it. I don't know. But yep, that is it for this Goodwill Outlet haul. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like and subscribe to see more videos. Bye!